we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section algebra. This problem is on polynomial rings. This problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020 and it is from the section B. The problem is, which of the following statements is not true? The four options are given to us. Option 1, the polynomial ring Z bracket X, Z over X is a principal ideal domain PID. Option 2, the polynomial ring QX is a PID. Option 3, the polynomial ring ZX is a unique factorization domain UFD. Option 4, the polynomial ring QX is a UFD, that is unique factorization domain. Let us first recall what is a principal ideal domain. An integral domain R is said to be a PID if every ideal in R is a principal ideal. What do you mean by a principal ideal? That is, every ideal has the form generated by a bracket A, that is every ideal is generated by a single element A bracket A, that is equal to the set of all multiples of A, R A, where R belongs to R, for some A in R. That means if there exists some element A in R such that this happens, then every ideal is of this form, therefore every ideal is a principal ideal, thereby R becomes a PID. And we recall a theorem, let F be a field, then the polynomial ring F over X is a PID. It's a very well known result. But we know Q is a field, Q, the set of real numbers, is a field, then the polynomial ring Q over X is a PID. So let's look at our options. And our option 2 is precisely that. That is, the polynomial ring Q over X is a PID. Therefore, the option 2 is true. Let's continue. Now, we recall a UFD. What is a UFD? To be an UFD, it must be basically an integral domain. An integral domain D is said to be a UFD if every non-zero, non-unit element of D can be written as a product of irreducible elements of D. That means every non-zero, non-unit element of D can be written as a product of irreducible elements of D, and this factorization is unique. That is, the factorization into these irreducible elements is unique up to associates and the order in which the factors appear. And we have a theorem. The theorem is, every PID is a UFD. Just now we have seen Q over X, the polynomial ring, is a PID. Therefore, it is a UFD. Look at our options. And this option Q over X, the polynomial ring is a UFD, is there in the option 4. So the option 4 is true. But we have to find out that statement in these four options which is not true. So these two statements are true. And let's see further. and we have the U of D. Yes. And we have the famous fundamental theorem of arithmetic, and by that theorem Z, the ring of integers, is a UFD. So by the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, the ring of integers Z is a UFD. And we have another result. If D is a UFD, then the polynomial ring D over X is a UFD. So Z is a UFD. The polynomial ring Z over X is a UFD. So this says ZX is a UFD, that is the option 3 is true. And let's look at the options 2, 3, 4 are true. And we have to find out that option which is not true. And it is a problem from the section B where only one answer is true. Therefore, students will put option 1 as their answer. Thus, option 3 is true. Since options 2, 3, 4 are true and it is a question from the section B wherein only one answer will be there, therefore, and we have to find out that option which is not true, and hence the option 1 is not true. Therefore, our answer is option 1. So, that's the end of that problem. But I want to show you that option 1 is not true means what? The polynomial ring ZX is not a PID. ZX is not a PID. So how do you show that? That means we will exhibit an ideal which is not a principal ideal. So what is that example? So let's look at that, and we write down the proof of the polynomial ring Z over X is not a PID. So for this, you have to exhibit an ideal which is not a principal ideal. That means we show that the ideal, this is the particular ideal what we are talking about, the ideal generated by 2 and X. 2 is a constant polynomial, X is a polynomial of degree 1. And the ideal generated by 2 comma X in ZX. And we will show you that it is not a principal ideal. That is, it is not generated by any polynomial. Assume the contrary. That is, you assume that it is a principal ideal. Then that means this ideal can be generated by a polynomial, say fx. So that is, there exists a polynomial fx belongs to zx such that I is equal to the ideal generated by 2 comma x is equal to the ideal generated by fx. So now what we do is 2 belongs to I. 2 belongs to I. 2 belongs to I. Therefore, 2 is an element of the ideal generated by fx. That means 2 is a multiple of fx. That means there exists some gx in zx such that 2 is equal to fx into gx. Let's take the degree on both sides. The degree of 2 is equal to the degree of fx into gx, and we know the degree of fx into gx is equal to degree of fx plus gx, and the degree of 2 is 0 because it is a constant polynomial, and the degree is a non-negative integer, and degree of fx plus degree of gx is equal to 0 will imply degree of fx is equal to degree of gx is equal to 0. So that means who are fx and gx? They are constant polynomials. So that means thus fx and gx are constant polynomials, and let us say fx is equal to a, where a belongs to z, gx is equal to b, where b belongs to z. So then by the above, 2 is equal to fx into gx. What is fx? Fx is a into gx is b. That means 2 is equal to ab, but this is the game going on in z. So AB is equal to 2 means either A is equal to plus or minus 1, or A is equal to plus or minus 2. A is equal to plus or minus 1, or A is equal to plus or minus 2. We continue in the next slide. So what we have seen is A is equal to plus or minus 1, or A is equal to plus or minus 2. we deal with the two cases. In each of the cases, we get a contradiction, and hence this argument is not possible. So first, let's take the first case. If A is equal to plus or minus 1, then you know the I is the ideal generated by 2 comma x is the ideal generated by fx. Now fx is equal to fx is equal to a is equal to plus or minus 1. Therefore, it is the ideal generated by a is equal to plus or minus 1. So that is the ideal generated by 1. That is the ideal generated by 1. So therefore, this 1 can be written as a combination of 2 and x, because 1 belongs to I and I is generated by 2 comma x. Therefore, 1 can be written as a combination of 2 and x. That means there exists polynomials px qx belongs to zx such that 1 is the combination of 2 and x, that is 2 into px plus x into qx. Now let's look at here, x into qx doesn't have a constant at all, because it starts with x, because qx is a polynomial. But 2 into px, there is a constant, let's be a naught plus a1x plus so on and so forth. So if you equate the constant terms on both sides, so the constant term on the left hand side is 1, on the right hand side is 2 times of the constant of the px, that is 2 into p naught, and the constant term is not there because the polynomial starts from x. So where p naught is an integer, so 2 is an integer, p naught is an integer, and a 2 times p naught is equal to 1. In integers, this is not possible. This is not possible. So this is not possible since p naught belongs to z. So the case 1 is not true. So let's look at the second case. If a is equal to plus or minus 2, then the ideal I is equal to the ideal generated by 2 comma x, the ideal generated by f of x, that is the ideal generated by plus or minus 2, that is the ideal generated by 2. So now let's look at this x. X belongs to I. So the x belongs to I means, so x must be written as a multiple of 2. So a multiple of 2 means there exists an Rx belongs to Zx such that x is equal to 2 times Rx. This means what? R of x, that polynomial, is equal to 1 by 2 times x, where 1 by 2 is not an integer, it's a rational number. That means it says it is a polynomial with the rational coefficients. Therefore, Rx doesn't belong to Zx, and hence you get a contradiction. This shows that the ideal I, so in both the cases you get a contradiction. So this shows this ideal I generated by 2 comma x in the polynomial ring Zx is not a principal ideal. Therefore, the polynomial ring Zx is not a PID. So that is the proof of the statement Zx is not a PID. This completes the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section algebra, and the problem is on polynomial rings, and all the 4 options given in this example are well known results. The students normally look at them and find out the options 2, 3, 4 are true and option 1 is not true, and they immediately put that statement which is not true as the option 1. It is very simple question. I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem. I wish you all the best. Thank you.